There are some chilling new details now on the final moments of an Air France Airbus before it crashed into the Atlantic Ocean two summers ago, 2009. The recently recovered flight data and voice recorders reveal the jet lost speed. It began what's called a wing stall, and then began a terrifying 3.5-minute fatal plunge into the ocean. The crash of that Air France flight claimed all 228 lives on board. The flight bound from Brazil to Paris. Peter Goelz is an aviation expert, former managing director of the National Transportation Safety Board, a man who has investigated personally several high-profile aviation accidents. Peter, what are you taking from the initial reports that we've gotten from this Air France, from the flight data recorders?
Well, the early indications point towards confusion in the cockpit and a inability of the flight crew to diagnose what was going on. They lost their airspeed indicator, and inexplicably, they pulled the nose up of the aircraft and put it into that wing stall, which was a fatal mistake.
I have here a model of an Airbus A300. This is the predecessor of the A330 that crashed. Apparently, they hit some turbulence, perhaps because the airspeed sensors were plugging up and weren't giving correct indications. The autopilot shut down, and the engines throttled back, so the plane naturally starts to tilt up like this. Rather than push the throttles forward and give it some more airspeed, well, they just never did that, and then you get what's called that wing stall, where the angle of attack of the wings won't support the plane, won't keep it in the air anymore.
Absolutely, and it's not uncommon in accidents sometimes where flight crews get fixated on one message or one part of the challenge, and they fail to scan their entire instrument panel. They fail to correctly diagnose that, you know, we're not getting good information off the airspeed indicator. There are training procedures you can go through that will offset that. Why they kept their nose up, why they allowed the stall to take place, why they made no attempt to fly out of it is simply inexplicable.
Right, because if you keep your nose up too much, and apparently they kept it at an angle greater than 35 degrees.
Right, almost 40 degrees.
Right, through the entire crash. So that plane is dropping, but dropping nose up, more than 30,000 feet in 3 minutes, 11,000 feet per minute. For the people on board, it had to be absolutely terrifying, and apparently nobody thought to just ram the throttles forward and give some power to the engines.
Right. If they'd pushed the throttles to the wall and pushed the nose down, they had plenty of altitude to fly out of this situation. But we've seen it before. As I say, you know, these pitot tubes have had a problem in the past. They've been replaced now.
The pitot tubes measure the airspeed.
That's right. It gives you the airspeed, and they fixated on that. And boy, it was a horrific accident.
It's hard to believe, with three pilots in the cockpit, one of them very experienced, that some of these mistakes were made. But the official report, I guess, is yet to come out. Peter Goelz, formerly with the National Transportation Safety Board. Thank you.